Dearly beloved, if this love only exists in my dreams, don't wake me up.
We arrived in Santarém, Brazil, where our site director, Micah Gregory, picked us up.
He took us to Fundação Esperança, and that night we played soccer with Brazilian medical students.
I feel so close to you right now. It's a force field.
Early that morning, Micah took us out along with two Brazilian medical students, KG and Aline, to see the Brazilian supermarket.
We walked along the Amazon River and got to see pink dolphins. Water levels were high for the dry season and streets were flooded.
We continued the day by going to a Brazilian mall and supermarket. That night we went out for some Brazilian food and drinks.
We woke up early and boarded a double-decker boat with a team of nurses from Project Quilombo. We traveled 24 hours to the furthest of three isolated communities where we would help provide medical care.
In order to make room for the medical supplies, we all slept on hammocks instead of beds. And as we headed down the Amazon River, the scenery was increasingly beautiful.
We woke up to arrive at the first and furthest village. The community members helped unload the medical supplies from the boat to the newly built schoolhouse in the center of the community.
The clinic consisted of nine stations: triage, men's health, pediatrics, growth and development, prenatal, gynecology, pharmacy, lab, and vaccination. The WVU students broke up into pairs and rotated through some of them.
Our group started in men's health and then rotated to pediatrics, where we observed two small girls getting IVs for vomiting, diarrhea, and dehydration.
Ethel, the head nurse, explained all the symptoms and described the medicine that she was prescribing them. We rotated to the prenatal station and saw an examination of a pregnant mother and listened to the heartbeat of the baby.
We stayed in that first community that next morning, where our group did triage, and traveled to a second community that afternoon and observed gynecology. We learned that Project Quilombo originated 13 years ago, and the medical team had made trips to these communities once a month ever since.
In each community, there's about 350 people, 10 to 11 kids per family. This amounts to 20 patients per session per nurse. The nurses follow a guideline called SOAP: subjective, objective, analyze, and prescribe. That morning, we continued at the second community with peds, where we saw about 20 kids, many with vomiting, diarrhea, strep throat, fever, bacteria, anemia, and sickle cell.
We traveled to the third community that evening. We helped with filing and learned how to test for blood type in the lab. Descendants of the slave refugees that settled the Quilombo region had O-positive blood unless there was a non-slave in their family history.
Within the lab, we also got to see malaria in a microscope.
This was our last day, and we remained in the third community. We started in pediatrics and finished the day in gynecology. By this time, Ethel and Luz Cleia could tell us the prescription patients needed, and we would write them in Portuguese. We also helped label their diagnoses with the International Code of Disease.
Most of the communities are 10 hours away from a hospital by boat. That is why most patients that come to the clinic expect to get medicine. Ethel and Luz Cleia, along with some of the other nurses, were great with helping the students overcome the language barrier. The nursing students were definitely no exception.
After traveling through the night, we arrived back in Santarém, where we rested most of the day. We went out for pizza that night with the group for our first formal goodbye party.
Early the next morning, we went to a daycare and called Ciara for undernourished children. Later that evening, we went on a wet hike where we all got really muddy. When driving to the Ciara house that morning, we noticed some of the biggest ditches we've ever seen, which made for an interesting ride.
The kids were happy to see us return to the daycare. We played with them, bathed them, and fed them before having to say goodbye.
Say hi!
Later that night, we went to the university in Santarém to see a form of martial arts called capoeira. It's a mix between fighting and dancing.
Late that night, Micah took us out for Brazilian sushi and the power went out. We had to light up our sake with our cell phone lights to see.
That morning, we started off the day by going on a dry hike where we learned about some of the native trees and plants of Brazil.
We went to a Brazilian barbecue buffet for lunch. They brought various meats to our table to try, including cow and chicken hearts.
We went souvenir shopping for the last time and then went to the university to tour the medical campus.
There was no beach at the beach community due to the flooding. We found a shop that sold Brazilian ivory and then stayed for dinner.
On the last day, we both woke up early and went to a Catholic church nearby. Then we had a final lunch where we said our goodbyes to everyone.
The journey back home was a long one. We made stops in Belém and Rio. There was a long layover in New York, so we traveled into the city to eat, shop, and sightsee. I may not have been able to help much in the clinic, but my experiences will forever shape my future as a physician.
The most beautiful journeys are the ones that you least expect. I'm